Hi everybody, this is Ellen. In this tutorial I'm going to show how to make the happy pickle. I think it's super cute. It's a smaller design which uses I think the least amount of bands at 180, which is nice for those who want to make a happy food, but I know they are band heavy, a lot of them, so you get your own little happy food. I am going to add little bumps this time around, just so it kind of reminds me more of a pickle, but you don't have to add them if you don't want to. That's up to you. So like I said, it's around 180 bands. If you add, I'm going to add, I think, 14 bumps to it. So if you want to have 14 extra bands, to do that too. And then 1 to 3 black bands, depending on if you use the 7mm pony beads for the eyes. And then 2 cheek bands. So, of course, it's all on one loom in a growing up design. Love the cute little curve. So we'll get started. Go through the eyes and the cheeks first, and the wrapped bands if you want to do the bumps. So for the eyes, you can either do a wrapped band or a bead. If you want to do a wrapped band, it's just one band, whatever color you want your eye to be, on the hook, wrap it around one time into a figure eight, grab both bands, wrap them around again, and then pull through, yikes, it's an ugly band, pull through 2 bands, whatever color you want your pickle to be, through the center, like that. So you make 2 of these if you wanted a wrapped eye band. If you're using a bead, you're going to want to find something that you can get into a V-shape. I'm using craft wire, but you use like twist tie, string, thread, floss, anything like that. Take 2 bands, the color of your pickle, drop them in the center, close that up, and thread it through the center of your bead. Pull your bead down to the middle, take out your tool, and then you have a beaded eye band. So you need 2 of those, or 2 of these, whichever one you're going with. Then the cheeks are made just like the eyes, just with a different color. So it's whatever color you want your cheek, on the hook, wrap it around one time, grab both bands, wrap them around again, and then pull through 2 bands the color of your pickle. Like that. And then, like I said, the bumps, it's made the same way as the eyes and the cheek. It's just one band. I'm using the same color as my pickle, so they're not like super noticeable, but they'll be there. So it'll be one band on the hook, wrap it around the figure eight, and wrap them around again, and then pull through 2 bands. Like I said, I'm using about 14 of them, but you don't have to if you don't want to. So like that. So, also, this is the, it's like pine green or dark green from Rainbow Loom, and then I'm using metallic green, which is out of a, it was a multicolor package from Rainbow Loom that was sold, I think is only sold in Michael's stores. I don't even know if they have them out anymore. They seem to kind of disappear and then come back. But I think I've seen them other places too. They are Rainbow Loom bands, but they're just only sold at Michael's stores. But I think they have similar ones if you're interested on rainbowloom.com too. So it's up to you. But whatever color, it's your pickle. So, one loom. We're just going to work on 6 pins, so kind of anywhere you want. We'll start by making a starburst. So from find a center pin, and then we're going to go out to the 6 pins around with 2 bands. Like that. And you want 2 bands for a cap band. We'll wrap them around 3 times. One keeps slipping off. Stay. Like that. So now we'll go in through the cap band and loom out the bands underneath. So in through the cap. Grab the top 2 bands, pull them up, and loom back towards themselves. And do the same thing for the other ones. Make sure you grab both bands. the next two. So now we're also going to add a stem to our guy. Just a little tiny one. It's usually the parts I cut off the pickle when I find them in the jar. But we're going to start with one band on the hook. Wrap it around one time. Grab both bands, wrap them around again. Then take another band on the end of the hook. Double it. And then you're going to pull that through the bands that are on your hook. Like that. And do that again. Doubled on the end, pull it through. One more time. Doubled and pull through. Like that. So what we're going to do is I'm going to pick up the top two bands on this pin right here, slide down half of the top, so it looks like that, and I'm going to take the bands and put them back onto the pin. So now I still have one half of my top on my hook. And I'll just kind of turn around, and I'll come back to the other side, across from it, grab the top two bands, pull those through what's left on my hook, and then put those back. So it's just attached there to the top. So now we'll do a row around. Two bands all the way around. Like that. Then we'll go ahead and we'll flip over the bottom four all the way around. Your bands down. And like I said, I'm going to add a few bumps to mine. If you're going to add them, I would probably add them in the same kind of spots that I do, just because we do, to get the curve in there, we do some kind of special banding, and if you put them in the wrong spot, you might not enjoy where it is after you're done. So I made one, but it looked, I used colors that were not so pretty, so just doing it the right way this time. So right here will be two bands. Then I'll do a bump band right here. And I'll pull it out. Yeah. Slippery. Then two bands. And a bump band. Two bands, and a bump band, like that. And again, you'll flip over the bottom four all the way around. Pulling it off the pin there. And push your bands down. Now we'll do another row around. Just two bands all the way around. Like that. Flip over the bottom four. texture bands down. Now I'll do another round with some bumps on it. So that'll be the bump band here, and two bands, then a bump band, two bands, bump band, and two bands, like that. And remember, you can skip the bump bands, it's not necessary to do them. And flip over the bottom four all the way around. And push your bands down. Now we're going to do a half row. How we're going to do that is a single band right here, then a double band, or two bands, right here, two bands right here, two more bands right here, and then a single right here. So we're going to flip over some bands on these four pins on this side. So here it'll be the bottom four, and the bottom four again, bottom four, and bottom four. Then we don't do anything on these two pins. Now we're going to do another half row. This one we'll put a bump on. Single band first, right here. Two bands, then a bump band, then two bands, and a single band. So like that. Then again, we're just going to flip over on these four pins, not over here. So there'll be three bands to flip over. This one will have four, this one will have four, and the top one right here will have three. Push your bands down. So now we're going to do a row round. We're going to do two bands all the way around, except for over here. We're going to do a double the band. So two bands, two bands, two bands. Then right here we'll take one band and we'll double it and put that in this spot. And then two more bands. So two bands on all these, and then this is one band doubled. So now we'll go around and we'll flip over the bands underneath. We only want to leave, like on right here, to be the doubled band and then the two bands. So you're going to flip over the bottom six bands. These are the two singles that we put on from before. And then the bottom four. So two singles and the bottom four. Then right here in the front, it'll be three. And four, four, and three. And push your bands down. So now we have our eye row. So you'll want your eyes. And we'll also add a bump. So right here in the front is where we'll add our eyes. So right here. And the one right next to it. Then right here we're going to do two bands. Then we'll have a bump band back here. and two bands. Then right here we're going to have another double band. You can, if you want, put the bump on it or leave it off. It doesn't really matter a whole lot. I do need to remake one that I broke because I didn't make extra. But right here, one band, doubled. And then you can put a bump on it if you want. But I'm going to skip it, so like that. So we'll go around and it should be the bottom four all the way around, or what looks like the bottom four. The double bands look like two bands, so I'm going to flip those over. Like so. Push your bands down. Now we're going to do our cheek row. And they're going to go right in the front here where the eyes are. There's one. And two. And then it's two bands all the way around the rest. That. Flip over the bottom four. Pickles are actually one of my favorite snacks, but it's weird because I have to have pickles that are like these, and then I cut them up and then have them with like cheese. I can't just like take dill pickles that are already cut and have those. I have to actually cut up the pickle. It's weird. I don't know. Apparently I think they taste different. So push your bands down. Now we'll put on the mouth band. So whatever color you want your mouth to be, you put that on your hook and wrap it around one time into that figure eight. And then you'll come in the front here between the cheeks, grab those bands that are on the pin, lift them up, slide your mouth band down, and then put the bands back onto the pin. You're slippery. Like that. Then we'll do another row around. We'll add some bumps again this time. So it's two bands. Put right here. And then a bump. So bump. And then two bands. And then another bump. And two bands and another bump. Like that. Flip over the bottom four all the way around. I actually make pickles too. The refrigerator pickles, they're delicious. The rest of my family, of course, isn't real into them, but oh well. Push your bands down. Now we're going to do a half row. So again, single band right here in the front on the left side. And then two bands. Oops. And two bands. Two bands and a single, like that. So then again, we're only going to flip over bands on these four pins. So right here in the front, four bands again, and four back here. Like so. Push your bands down. Like that. Then we're going to do another half row. And although technically I would put some bumps on this one, I'm actually going to skip it and do it with on to the next full row. So, but single band right here. Then two bands. Two bands. Two bands again. And a single. Like that. And once again, we're only flipping on these four pins over here. So in the front it's three. And four. Four. And three up here at the top. Alright, so this row be a bump band right here. Then two bands. Then a bump band. Then two bands. And right here, again, will be one band doubled. And then in the front will be two bands. Like that. So again, we're going to flip over on these ones. It'll be six bands. It'll be those two singles from the last row, and then the bottom four. The two singles and the bottom four. And up here in the front, it'll be three, four on these sides, and three back here on the top. Like so. Push your bands down. So we're going to do a row round, except we're going to have a doubled band right here again. So two bands. Two bands. Two. This is where we put the doubled one, but I'm actually going to put a bump on it this time. So I'm just pulling that off. The two bands. Doubling a band. So we want a doubled band in this spot. So the bump is just going to be on a doubled band. And then two bands in the front. Like so. So we'll flip over the bottom four all the way around. Push your bands down, and then we're going to do one last row all the way around with two bands, just normally. It's actually a game we played when we were little with a pickle. But it was at Christmas time, we'd put a pickle on the, or somebody would hide the pickle on the tree, and then on Christmas Eve, we would look for it, and whoever found it usually got to either open presents first, or they got a special present, or so that's kind of what this reminds me of with the coloring. It's all the way around with the two bands. So then you go and you flip the bottom four all the way around. that. Push your bands down. Then what we're actually going to do is go around and we're going to flip over the bottom two bands. So make sure you have the bottom two. Grab those and just flip them over the top. So now we can close our pickle. So I'm just going to take my hook, go in through kind of the back side, and start putting the bands on my hook. I'm hanging on over on the other side so that they don't pop up. Like that. Then I'm going to take two bands and pull them through both ends on my hook. And before I close them, I'm going to try to kind of tighten it up a little bit, shape it. So once you close it, you can't really move the bands around. And then I'll do a slip knot and close it up. And then we'll hide our tail. Yes, much better than my first one. That I did a different color dots on them, and I didn't like that very well. You can also see the difference in bands, how the size looks different. I don't know why, but these ones seem really thin to me compared to the other ones, that just other bands in general. But I think it turns out super cute. Cute little pickle. There really is a size difference too. That's kind of weird. So, I hope you enjoyed it. I think it's cute. I know people ask for it, and sometimes I'm really bad about doing kind of the simplistic designs, just because I worry that I kind of set the bar pretty high for myself, I think, so with the kind of designs I do, and sometimes I forget that a lot of people, you know, they want simpler designs because they want to be able to make them, and they're just not quite there yet. Not yet, anyways, but they will be with the looming skills, so definitely trying to get back and get some of those other easier ones done for them, so it's important to me. But I hope that you enjoyed this. I hope that you love your little pickles, and that you like the... I think the bumps look fabulous. But I want to thank you very much for watching. If you make some of these, I would definitely love to see them. And you can tag me on my Instagram, which is at CraftingFantastic, or show me on my Facebook page, which is feelinspiffy or CraftingFantastic. There's a link underneath the video. And of course, if you subscribe to my channel, that would be fabulous. Then you can see when I come out with new designs. And I will definitely have more for you soon. I'm working all the time, trying to kind of create new and different things and meet all requests. And it's just, it's a lot of fun for me. So I'm enjoying it. So I hope you're enjoying it. But thanks again. I'll have more for you soon.